Yes, good morning children. Now yesterday we learned the lesson number 14, the clothes we wear. The clothes we wear red. Now yesterday Kenyani, we will just do a recap. Why do we wear clothes? How it helps us? Some questions children?
It protects
us. From what? It protects us from?
Yarn means thread.
thread. So cotton thread, then silk, and then it is made the clothes. Then it is dyed, then it is printed, and then it is all the dyeing thing. It's a lot of process you will learn, which you in second standard little. Third standard you will be learning more about all this textile, how it is done, chemicalized, polish, what is polyester, what is all that about yarn. You will learn in third standard. Okay, now little I'll just give you this hint. How you may be wondering how we are getting from the worm, how we are getting from the plant, the cotton plant, like the balls of cotton will be there this way. Like you can see in the plant, where this is cotton, you can see there cotton. So this is which we get it from plant only. Okay, then they take it and silk also from that worm we are getting that fiber, and that it is they are putting that worms in on the plants. It is mostly found in Bangalore and all. I told you I'll show the video, but it is when I search some videos, it was very high, which larva and all, which you will not understand. But we need still we will search. If you are coming on 17th, I will show you on the smart board also, or it may be the next class. Definitely I will show about this searching. I'm making and clubbing the PPT for your very sake. Yesterday when we were searching, it was all about very high. About the silk product, how we are getting that fiber and all. Okay, so cotton is with the plant is fiber, then this all silk from that fiber, all that thread that you know that is called yarn. So it goes to factories or in the big industries, textile industries, where we have the weavers spinning yarn. We all that machines are there. There they thread, they polish it, they make that. Then they that it goes to some machines, and then it is made as a cloth, then it is dyed, printed, and then it is coming to the shop, bar. Understood? Now you can see my dress dupatta also. You can see color. Now this was some synthetic material, the polyester synthetic. You will learn in that standard, I said. So this dye color, they put this color to that material, blue color, and then the print, like this dot, the print. So this is what the process is there. You will learn more about this. You will go on keeping learning. Okay, now you will learn about what, from where these fibers we are getting from. Okay, cotton we are getting from cotton plant, silk we are getting from silkworm, and woolen clothes. Now we'll come to woolen clothes. When we wear these woolen clothes, Now which season is going on? Which season? Winter. Very cold. Yes, very cold. I hope you yes, when winter. And we can you just give me example of winter clothes? Give me examples of winter clothes. Gloves, hand gloves, okay, mufflers, which is are there, okay? Yes. Okay, then jackets, okay, socks. So this, what it, how it helps this woolen clothes? Yes, woolen clothes, yes. Animal. We are getting from animal. Which animal?
Sheep and yes.
We get sheep. Yes. We get wool from sheep and hair. Yes. And how this woolen clothes help us in winter season? How it helps us in winter season? Woolen clothes. Faster, you have to come. How it helps? It keeps us warm. It keeps us warm. How cotton clothes keep us cool and light? That way woolen clothes keep us warm. Why? Winter is cold. Okay? Okay, all understood. Very good. Now we will go for Next, page number 77. Page number 77. Raining. All like rain? All like rain? Everybody likes rain, I think so. Page number 77, children. Okay? Page number 77. All everybody likes rain? Everybody
yes. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Okay, now
yes,
ma'am. Yes, now yes, ma'am. Okay, when it rains, no? When it rains, how you will come to school? You will come that way only?
No, ma'am.
Then what? No, ma'am. How you will come?
No,
ma'am. Huh?
No, ma'am.
Rainbow. Very good, darling. Okay? We, yes.
Okay.
Raincoat, then gumboots. Gumboots are like this, yes. Gumboots are this type of shoes, okay, where they are long, which protect us from rain, okay? Which protects, these are the gumboots. You can see this raincoat and you can see this umbrella, okay? Umbrella. So we use this, yes. We did see, yes. Suhan, Arna, just mute your mobiles. Arna, Arun, Arna. Arna, mute your mobile. Okay, some things help us stay dry when it rains. For example, raincoat and gumboots. You also carry an umbrella when it rains, okay? So some clothes which keeps us dry that we wear during rainy season, for example, raincoat and gumboots. And during rain, we carry umbrella. We carry umbrella and the it wear raincoat. So it helps us to keep us dry during this clothes, this time raincoat and all. It helps us to keep our feet, gumboots, keep us dry. Even the umbrella that we will not get wet. Okay. Turn the page 78. Page 78. All
have
turned?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Now some, yes. Now some special clothes are there. Now for an example, how do you come to school? You wear colorful dresses?
Uniform.
Yes. Uniform. Okay. Yes, very good. We wear some special clothes. Yes. Special, yes. Special set of clothes which we wear it as a uniform. Only school children wear uniform? Only school children?
No, ma'am. Only the girls wear.
Who is can you give
postman?
Postman. Yes. Policeman. Yes. Police officers. Securities. Doctors. Okay? See, all have their according to their profession, according to their job. They wear their uniform. Then we come to know. Now how we come to know their doctors? If they carry injection? No, no. They wear that white apron. What is
white?
Yes, it is not called coat, it is called apron. Okay? The word doctors wear that white one, no, it is called apron. Okay? Did you understand? So,
yes.
Seeing that only we come to know, yes, he's the doctor. Then seeing the police officer, all the cap, the stars, okay? We come to know he's a police officer, he's a policeman. And postman, he carries that bag and that khaki uniform. We come to know that he's a postman. Yes? Yes or no? Then we see the security people wearing that blue uniform. They also have different. But we come, it is written all their security, their names, badges are there. So they wear those clothes which we can identify what they are, what job they are doing. Okay, that is called profession. What in profession are there? So, uniform. Now, all school also. Now all school have same uniform? All school have same uniform?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am. Yes. Very good. Yes. All have. Yes. Different uniform. So even our school have different uniforms. Some other school in Belgaum, other cities, towns, we have different uniforms. Okay, then we wear. Okay, so that presents us. Yes, our uniform, what you wear every day. We come to know how these are the Good Shepherd Central School children. Through that uniform only, it shows your identity that you all are Good Shepherd children. Who are you? Okay, so you, that uniform, a special set of clothes that people wear according to their work is called uniform. Okay, a special set. You can see even in school, you all wear that uniform. You will come to know you all are Good Shepherd children. You can see your aunties also, they are also having uniforms. Do you know that? You can, you see, no, every day when you are in school?
Yes, ma'am.
Aunties,
yes, ma'am. Yes,
bus drivers. Yes. Yes. You see, no, aunties, they got that uniform.
Yes, ma'am.
All aunties wear that same type of clothes, you know, that uniform. Even they are having. Drivers are having. Yes. Okay, even some school teachers also have. We wear that particular sarees also. That is like a school saree. Okay, we wear during national festivals. We wear. Okay, even we have uniform. Even some school every day it has. So everybody that represent the profession or job you are doing, where are which school, all that it shows the identity of that is of a girl. Okay, so according to a special set of clothes that people wear according to their work is called uniform. Here are the examples of some uniforms. You can see in your picture, doctor, then police officers, a policeman is there. Okay, and some pictures also, some more we will see in some other things. You can see the, so this is, we learned about uniforms. Can anyone tell me anything about uniforms? Anybody wants to say something about uniforms?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, say.
Yes, ma'am.
Say, tell.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. What is? Listen to
me. Yes, ma'am.
Listen, children. I'm asking some question. That is, listen first what the teacher says. Okay, don't say yes. I'm asking, can anyone wants to give any some more example of uniforms? Something you want
to say? Very nice.
Huh?
Our uniform is very nice.
Yes, our uniform looks nice. See, when we wear, now different color children coming in, you know, one day it is nice, but every day it is not good, no? When you come in uniform, the proper tie, the collar, your blazers, okay, the shoes, the socks, all that uniformity, it looks very nice. Very good, Arohi. It looks nice. It looks neat and nice. It shows the identity, okay, that what we are and which work we are. But that uniform also represent the things which we school, how we are coming, okay? Wearing that full uniform, very presentable and looks nice. Very good. Okay? So far we have learned about the special clothes, the uniform also. Now, linen is one of the old fabric used of by, that is the fact corner. Many linen and all polyester and all you will learn in the next classes. Okay, all are ready. Everybody understood the lesson? Everybody understood the lesson?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubts? Any doubts? Any doubts, children?
No, ma'am. No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. Now, take your pencil in your hand. All have done this homework?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now I'll ask you, in number one picture, they have given the numbers, as I told you. Numbers they have given and you have to write it here. So, first picture in your cupboard, in that picture cupboard, what it is?
Socks
and?
Socks.
Socks and?
Pants.
Pants. Okay.
Pants.
Okay. All have written? Second picture. Second
cap.
Cap and? Cap and?
Hat.
Hat. Cap and hat is there. Third picture.
Long.
Belt. Third picture is belt. B-E-L-T. Belt. Okay, you should know all this. That is what I told you. You identify and gave you one day time. Okay. Fourth picture. Fourth
picture.
Gloves. What it is? Gloves. G-L-O-V-E-S. Gloves. You should find out now. Okay. Fifth picture. Fifth picture. In your that cupboard. Sweater. Yes, sweater. Fifth picture is that is in that cupboard. Sweater. Very good. Sixth.
Shoes.
Shoes. Very good. Seven.
Shoes.
Seven. Many things are there, seven.
T-shirt.
T-shirt. Yes, very good. Then?
T-shirt.
Then? Frog. Yeah, maybe it's a gum frog. Okay. Okay. Seventh. Eighth picture. What is there in there? Sandal. Okay. Ninth also it is given it as a frog or a trouser. What men wear? Okay, it is called as a trouser. What you will wear now as a long pant, that is called as a trouser. Okay, 10th picture.
Shoes and
boots. Shoes and
boots.
Okay, done. Now, page number 78, activity corner. Activity corner, page number 78, activity corner. All are holding the pencil in your hand? All are holding?
Yes.
Now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. I'll read. Read and listen now. Write the blue for the clothes that will keep you warm. C for the clothes that keep you clothed. And B for the things that keeps you dry on a rainy day. Okay? Now, first picture is what? Tell me. First picture.
Umbrella.
Umbrella. What do we write? W. W we write C or D?
D.
So, first picture. You will write D. In that box, you will write D. Write D. All are right. Write D. Why umbrella keeps us dry? D means dry. Okay, so umbrella keeps us dry, right? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. Second picture. You will write W or C? You will write W. Why? Which cloth it is? What it is? Tell me.
Sweater.
So, how? What sweater does it keeps us? Warm. So, W for warm. W for warm. Next is what? Next is what?
C.
What that picture is? What this picture is?
T-shirt.
And what is that C? What is that C? What? No? All our clothes. C means what? t-shirt, which it is a cotton one. Okay, cotton one that keeps us cool, dry, warm, cool. Okay, you should identify the pictures and then it is. Then remember also, D we are using it as dry, W as warm, C as cool. Okay, done. Now page 79. Fill in the blanks. A special set of clothes that people wear according to their work is called what? Dash. So what is the answer?
Uniform.
Now can anyone tell me the spelling?
U-N-I-F-O-R-M.
Uniform. When we told mammals is telling, we are also telling, when you are reading the lesson, underline the difficult words which you find. Okay, spellings also we have given. But even when you are reading, then you have to learn that spelling also. Okay, you all know all orally. Spellings also have to learn while reading. Okay, so special set of clothes that people wear according to their work is called uniform. Write that all. Second, this is first answer. Second, we get dash from silk worms.
Silk.
We get silk. From silkworm, we get silk fiber. We get silk fiber from silkworm. Understood?
Yes.
Finished?
No.
Yes.
Yes.
You can see after the video also, you can fill it by reading the lesson, you can do yourself also. Okay, now here subject, that is this. Now here we are doing something in English. So subject connect. So in EVS we are connected subject English. Okay, English. Fill in the blanks using the correct option. Now we have learned A and N. We have learned A and N. Yes or no?
Yes.
Now, Rahul is dash A and. So, what you will use that? Rahul is a soldier. Okay. He wears dash uniform. What you will use there?
And.
Why you are using and there? Because you for uniform. U is a consonant or a vowel?
Vowel.
Okay. Then when he goes to the hospital, today it is raining, he has decided to carry dash umbrella. What you will use there?
And.
Very good. Okay. Very, very good. Okay. Now turn the page. Page 80.
I am done 80.
Okay, then I'll ask the question, you'll answer. Choose the correct option. We get wool from sheep. Option B, silkworm. C, cotton plant. Jute plant.
Sheep.
C. C is the correct option. You have to tick that option C. Silkworms gives us wool, silk, jute, cotton.
Silk.
So, second one, B option. Wait, Shaurya. Okay, third one. Which of the following things can be used on a rainy day? Umbrella, raincoat, both A and B. Which option?
Both A and B.
Very good. So, third one, C option is the correct one. If you use the on rainy day, we use umbrella also and raincoat. We use umbrella also and raincoat. Read the lesson.